Every time you smoke, blood that's thick and dirty with toxins circulates through your body in seconds, increasing your chances of a heart attack or stroke. Every 15 cigarettes you smoke will cause a mutation.
When you smoke, toxins attack your insides, causing your body to rot.
You'd think with all this media about how bad smoking is for your health, why don't we listen to it? According to ASH, Action on Smoking and Health, in March of 2017, less than 1 in 5 UK adults now smoke. Surveys from ASH in 2017 suggest that the majority of all smokers want to quit smoking, but only 30 to 40% of which actually make an attempt to quit each year. This here is David, and he wants to quit smoking. We'll follow him and give him the tools he needs in order to do so.
It really depends if I'm at college or if I'm spending time at home. If I'm at college, I usually smoke around a pack or more, but if I'm at home, I smoke around one or two a day.
So over the next 3 weeks, you're going to try three different methods of quitting smoking.
Okay.
The first method will be using nicotine replacement therapies. In this case, you'll be using patches.
Yes.
Have you ever tried them before?
No, I have never tried them. This will be interesting.
The second week will be done using vaping. Have you ever tried vaping before?
Yes, I did try vaping. I tried vaping when one of my friends allowed me to use his vapor, and I just loved the flavor, so I wanted to get one of my own and taste that flavor again.
Alright, this is how long after putting the...
About 5 hours.
About 5 hours, and if you peel it away, you can see that there's a red inflamed area, and David has expressed that he's getting pain. Or is it like a heat pain?
It's not even heat, it's just like full-on pain in the whole arm, across to the wrist.
This is a definite sign of an allergic reaction to something used in the nicotine patches. Due to this, I can't have David continue to use the nicotine patches. But an allergic reaction to nicotine patches isn't uncommon, as this lady can attest to.
I'd quit once for 5 months, and I went to the NHS and I used patches.
You can't let it go,
and that was very good.
Mm.
And then I became allergic to the patches.
What did the patches do?
It just made a reaction on my skin.
Well, like a red mark, for example?
Yeah, really red.
To find out more about the different methods to quit smoking, I'm going to be talking with a pharmacist who'll be able to tell me more. Unfortunately, the pharmacist wasn't comfortable talking to me in front of the camera, though he did answer my questions, and now I'll give those answers to you. He said they offer a 12-week course, giving you advice on how to quit. These would be changing your lifestyle choices, i.e. getting rid of your ashtrays and lighters. They also gave you your choice of patches, lozenges, inhalers, and gum. The most common treatment that they gave was nicotine patches, but they would also give you another method to aid in the more prominent cravings. They would give you an inhaler if they needed something to do with their hands, and gum if they needed something to do with their mouths. The pharmacy had a lot of success with people using the nicotine patches, so they said the patches were the most effective method for quitting. He said the majority of people are successful when they come to them in order to quit smoking. The advice that we would give someone to quit smoking is that you could tell them about the financial gain of quitting. The pharmacist would also tell you about the health benefits, being able to breathe more easily, being able to walk upstairs without being out of breath by the time you got to the top.
I wanted to find out what the public thought was the best method to quit smoking.
I think willpower. Willpower is the best way to quit smoking, otherwise you can't do anything.
Quit smoking? Strength will.
Strength alone?
And good, yeah. Relax and too much air smoking, yeah?
Yeah.
And very hard to low cigarette.
When you have too much stress, you know?
So he wanted to stay in the hotel,
but he needed food.
No,
he got self-distracted from smoking, composed, clutches.
Sandpix.
The tablets. Mm-hmm. They're really good. And the mints. They're all right. They're never lasting.
Patches. Patch for your arm.
The patches. I'll say
the nicotine
gum.
Get tablets.
Yeah.
Distract yourself.
Distraction with what?
Just anything that you can do to stop yourself from smoking.
So the general public tend to think that willpower and patches are the best method to quit. Although they do say that you have to want to quit smoking in order to quit smoking. Over the last week, David was seeing how effective vaping is as the method to quit smoking. This is his experience of vaping after the first day.
Mr. Lovett put me on a vape. It is, I can tell it's stronger than a cigarette. But the flavour is actually quite nice. What about the... because of the high nicotine percentage in the liquid, it burns the throat a bit.
In 2017, there are 2.3 million people who vape in the UK, 53% of which say that they vape because it's an aid to quit smoking. But why is vaping so popular these days? To find out, I had a talk with Ryan Draper, one of the managers at Make My Vape in Luton.
Unlike smoking, vaping is essentially the act of inhaling water vapor, essentially made up of propylene glycol and vegetable glycerin, with optionally flavor concentrates and a nicotine solution. In my opinion, vaping probably is the best way to quit smoking, as it hits two birds with one stone. You know, you got the addiction of wanting to put something to your mouth and breathe it in, and as well as that, you are also getting your nicotine hit from it. So I'd say nicotine patches and nicotine gum are along the same lines as electronic cigarettes. Nicotine patches and gums, they are also a nicotine substitute. Yes, that's the word. You know, it's a product that is trying to still give you nicotine satisfaction without getting all the harmful effects from a cigarette, you know, stuff like tar, carbon monoxide, acetonin, all these different chemicals that are in cigarettes that are the parts that are harmful to you. Unlike nicotine patches and gum, as I've said before, it also, you're also going to be craving the habit of being wanted to breathe something in and being able to put something to your mouth. You know, it's like half of it's going to be, you know, your nicotine addiction. And the other half is going to be the actual habit of being of putting something into your mouth and inhaling that. Smoke is something that's been burnt, whereas e-liquid is something that's vaporized, which are two completely different things. But burning is where, you know, you have to apply combustion into the mix, which is where all the nasty chemicals come from. You know, it's essentially like breathing into a bonfire. It's going to be dangerous. Whereas vaping, it's the same thing as breathing in water vapor while you're having a steamy shower. It is addictive, but it's going to be safer than smoking, is what we're trying to put across. I mean, in terms of, once again, the habit and the nicotine, although you can get rid of the nicotine in nicotine-free liquids. But I would still say vaping is addictive. That's why there are laws in place where, you know, you can't sell them to under 18s, the same as cigarettes. You know, we believe they should be treated in the same as cigarettes.
Vaping is incredibly popular these days. There are so many different companies. There are companies that produce e-liquids, different batteries, cotton, wire and atomizers. They have cloud competitions to see who makes the biggest clouds. There are also trick competitions to see who can manipulate their clouds into different shapes and forms. To do this, they need very specific devices and builds and a specific set of skills. So let's check back in with David and see what he thought of vaping and how effective he thought it is as a method to quit smoking.
What I can say about vaping is that it's hard to find. It's not really hard, but it might take a while for a person to find the right percentage of nicotine in the juice before they are satisfied with the kick. Also, I've smoked again because I forgot to recharge my vape and it died on me while I was outside.
When I asked the public earlier what they thought was the best way to quit, I also asked them what they thought was the worst way to quit.
Just trying to give it up straight away, especially if you've been using any kind of...
Well, most people think they have the willpower, but...
Yeah, using willpower alone, like, that kind of can... That mess
yeah,
up.
Because they're like, oh, I can quit smoking in a couple of days, but they go back to it.
Drinking.
So you think drinking is the...
Yeah, going from one bad habit
to the next.
Because
when you have a drink, it's like you want to fucking smoke as well, yeah?
It is still... better just to quit completely.
Yeah.
Vaping is purely there for the people who just cannot do that, who just cannot just quit at all, but still want to lead a healthier life.
It's cold. Cold food.
Just using willpower alone.
That never worked. It would never work.
Some people.
Yeah, but
sure.
But you got to be. Yeah, but he had a medical problem, didn't he? The doctor told him he had to back it up. Yeah. But I think. The only way you're ever going to give up smoking is if you want to give up smoking.
It's like quit smoking and not smoking anything. About stop smoking.
So, cold turkey?
Oh no, yeah. I smoked.
You can do it with willpower alone. I think it's a lot to do with just the habit of smoking more than the addiction.
David's final method of quitting is using willpower alone. Some people say that this is the hardest method to quit smoking with. But some people also say that this is the easiest method to quit smoking with.
Good for the first 3 days, but then it started slowly building up towards smoking again. So one cigarette on the fourth day, two cigarettes on the fifth day.
So you just couldn't keep
going
cold turkey?
Because I just found the work really stressful that I had in the moment.
So having stress makes quitting with willpower difficult.
Yeah, it does. It's just when you have to organize everything and sort it out, then go to this location, that location, get this done. And if something goes wrong, it's just more stress. You know, it all builds up, and then it's like the willpower is really overtaken by the, let's say, the want to smoke.
Over the last couple of weeks, I've been looking into the different methods you could use in order to quit smoking. I began my investigation by talking to David about his smoking habits. I then went to and had a talk with a pharmacist about different methods you could use in order to quit. Next, I spoke with Ryan Draper, who spoke about vaping as being more of an alternative to cigarettes than an actual way to quit. Finally, I asked members of the public what they thought was the easiest and most difficult ways to quit smoking. From this investigation, I found out that you have to want to quit in order to quit. There are things that help, such as nicotine patches, gums, inhalers, for example. But you have to want to quit in order to quit. It's very psychological. If you don't want to quit and people are pushing you to quit, you're not going to actually quit. That's just the simple story.